Look here, David. I won't ask you again. Will you kindly keep your beak shut? I am trying to watch the Riddlers. Thank you.
I knew you'd have trouble with young Middler. I just knew it. He's the most unreliable young rascal I ever did come across. And why you should offer to give him riddling lessons, I'll never know.
Well, it doesn't look as though I'll be giving him any riddling lessons now, does it?
Yeah.
Not if he doesn't turn up.
No. Well, I don't know where... Oh, hang on. Bike coming through. I don't know where... By heck, it's him! And he's on a bike as well. Wherever did he get that from?
You're late, young Middler.
Oh, hello. I thought I wouldn't have any riddling lessons today. I thought I'd go for a bike ride.
What? You thought what?
Do you like it? I borrowed it off one of my mates down the village. Woo! You come here, you get off your bike, and you come and have your riddling lesson, young Middler. I don't know what you're thinking about. Any road up, riding on a bike without a helmet, that's dangerous.
Dangerous.
Oh, you're an old fusspot, you are. And as for your riddling lessons, you can keep them. Hey, ta-da! Oi! Wait, come back here. Did you hear what he called me? An old fusspot. Did you hear that?
Never mind about that. Come on, let's get after him and bring him back.
Oh, you are joking, aren't you? I mean, what chance have we got of catching him when he's on a bike?
Aye, that's a point. Well, we'll just have to borrow one ourselves, won't we, eh?
Aye, well, I was going to suggest that, of course. Glossop? Glossop! Wait for me, Glossop! Glossop!
Do you think he'd mind us borrowing it?
Oh, Mr. Grimley? No. If he were here, he'd let us borrow it like a shot. No, he won't mind me riding his bike, won't Montgomery?
You? I didn't know you could ride a bike.
Oh, I can do anything if I set my mind to it, I can.
It's not half big.
Aye, well, that's no problem for a wonderful bike rider, like what I probably am.
Oh, don't just stand there. Give me a leg up.
Thanks. A bit more.
Oh, oh, it's a bit.
Oh, dear.
Oh. It is a big one, isn't it?
Aye.
Oh, dear, this is a problem and a half. Don't worry, though. I'll riddle it out. I've got it! Hey, you, stay there.
Yeah, I'm not hanging around here all day, you know. Not going to be easy on a bike this size. Still, I've ridden bigger ones at the circus.
Where did you learn to ride like that?
At the circus. Where else? Did I never tell you I did a trick cycling act?
Trick cycling, difficult and dangerous and quick cycling. It takes nerve, it takes skill. Years of training and a lot of will to master trick cycling, trick cycling, trick cycling. It's spectacular and slick cycling, falls and bumps every day. Cuts and bruises are the price you pay for learning trick cycling, trick cycling. You'll get hurt if anything goes wrong, but the thrill is hard to beat, and the world is at your feet. Trick cycling along. Trick cycling along.
Oi! That's my bike! Oi! Come here, Glossop!
Trick cycling indeed!
The very idea, and on my bike too!
Ha. Save your breath for pedalling, Mr. Grimley! We're catching him up! Faster! Faster!
Look, he's turning into Miss Dawes' garden! We've got him now!
Oh! Leave that! Oh, no. Oh. Midna, are you all right?
Oh, I hurt my head!
Well, you should have been wearing a helmet.
So, we've caught you at last, young fella, my lad.
Don't shout at him. He's hurt himself.
And I'm not surprised, riding like that.
Oh, and I damaged the bike as well. And it's not my own. Oh, I don't know what my mate's going to say when I give it back to him.
Oh, leave it to me. I'll fix it for you. Now, I must say, I don't think you deserve it.
Thank you, Mr. Grimley.
Yeah.
What are we going to do with you, young middler?
I don't know. Give me a good telling off, I suppose.
It's all those children in the village who've been leading him into trouble.
Aye, I know. It's a pity we can't take him away for a bit. Take him somewhere where he can't get into bad company. And the further away, the better.
Like where, for example?
Well, like France, for example.
France? But that's abroad, isn't it?
Aye, that's right, young middler. Well, I'm glad to see you paid some attention to your lessons. And if we took you to France, you'd have lessons there as well, you know. It wouldn't be just a holiday.
We couldn't take him to France, could we?
Of course we could. Well, if his mum agreed, there'd be me and you and Mossop to look after him. And it'd do him the world a good to learn about life in a foreign country.
I've never been abroad before.
Well, I have lots of times. You leave all the arrangements to me, eh?
Gosh, I can't wait to tell Marjorie.
Well, you'll have to. She's gone away for a couple of days.
Well, I can't wait to... I can't wait to tell Mossop then. Mossop! Mossop! Come and listen to this.
That's it, that's it. Lift, right, lift.
You call, Tiddlop?
Ah, careful. Whoa.
What on earth are those for?
Eh? Oh, these? Well, with these I'll be able to get on Mr. Grimley's bike. Easy peasy. Where is his bike, by the way?
Never mind about the bike, Mossop. We're going to France.
France? Whose daft idea was that? Well, hang on, just a minute. Whoa, again, whoa!
France, eh? I hope the ground's a bit softer out there.
Poor old Tatty Bogle's lost his voice today, but Stan might just have the answer. Next!
He's grown again!
Are you measuring those puppies again?
Yes. Puppies grow 8 times faster than children, so they need their own special food.
That's why I give them Pedigree Chum puppy food when they're little.
Then when they're 6 months old, like this chap, I put them on this new Pedigree Chum Junior.
Pedigree understand dogs like vets do, so the nutrition's absolutely right.
I wish I could grow that fast.
They're looking like champions already.
Pedigree Chum. Top breeders recommended.
Help is a new kind of insurance. We guarantee to authorise claims within 48 hours or give you your money back. For a great quote, ring 0800 112 233.
Tortilla chips are totally tastier when you spice them up with new Uncle Ben's salsa dips. The chunkiest tomatoes, crunchiest onions, tangiest peppers, and Uncle Ben's secret spices. There's hot, cool, and spicy cheese. Transform your tortilla chips. Spice them up with new Uncle Ben's salsa dips.
11 o'clock and it's time for break.
Oh.
It's time for Cadbury's Time Out.
When you're gasping, I'm asking for a break. And no chocolate, like a taste of Cadbury's Flake.
Delicious flake makers, crispy wafer, all covered in Cadbury's milk chocolate.
That makes a time out. Just take a time out. Cadbury's Time Out. No matter what you're doing, yeah, put a flake in your brain.
The Cadbury's Time Out.
There's so much fun for you to enjoy every Friday afternoon on CITV when you tune in for stories, poems, songs and much more. Jay's World, Friday, 3:30, CITV. But Tatty Bogle seems to have lost his voice. Can you see it anywhere, Abacat? No?
Wizadora, we adore her, doing things in her very special way. Wizadora, nothing surer, you're
the one that can brighten up our day. Gilbert, you frightened me.
What's wrong with your voice, Daddy?
I've lost my voice.
Oh, I'll look for it.
Owen. I mean, I slept in a cold draft without my scarf.
One, that's...
Oh.
It's no... My week tomorrow. There's so much to learn.
Oh, you'll be all right, Wizadora.
Oh, Pooh, turn down the volume.
Beep, beep, beep.
Will you stop that noise?
Beep, beep. Sorry, Wizadora, but you did ask me for an alarm call at 7:30 this morning.
Morning? I haven't even been to bed yet.
That means the wizard's test is today, Wizadora.
Today? Oh, no! You know, Pooh, you're much louder than usual.
Beep, beep.
Oh, sorry, Wizadora. It's those draw people. They always turn up my volume when they're playing computer games.
Oh, that's better. Oh.
I never understood tired.
No. Machines don't get tired, do they? Lucky old you.
Wizadora!
Oh, quiet, please. I've got to get some sleep.
That wasn't loud. Wizadora!
Beep, beep!
We have visitors!
Oh, it's you. Hello. Nice of you to drop off. In. I'm sorry, I'm whacked. I've been trying to learn some spells for my wizard's exam.
So, you see, Tatty, Nigel said I was no good at seaweed arranging. Me! And if there's one thing I won't have, it's a snail telling me how to arrange seaweed. Oh, you're not saying much, are you?
I've lost my voice.
You what? Oh, I see. You've lost your voice, eh? Never catch an old sea dog losing their voice, and you know why.
No. I'm sure you're going to tell me.
Eh? Salt water. A quick gargle of the old briny and your voice will be as loud as a foghorn.
Come on, Wizadora.
But I need to rest and study for my wizard's exam.
But Daddy's lost his voice.
Well, I've lost a night's sleep. Can't the draw people help?
The draw people help?
Did someone call?
Someone mentioned sweets to eat.
When someone's in trouble,
we need to listen.
By sucking sweets and munching crisps. Yum, yum.
Oh, I hate loud noises first thing in the morning.
Look, will you lot help Tatty to get his voice back, please?
Yes.
So, I said to this young lobster, I said, if you want to know all about seaweed arranging, I'm your man. First of all, you have to choose your seaweed, and my jingo, there's plenty to choose from.
I just want my voice
down in the ocean
back.
Bed. All you have to do is swim...
We've got some cures, Tatty.
What you need to get your voice back is to suck a lemon.
No, Tutty. The best cure is to suck a clove of garlic.
No, Tutty. What you need to do is to suck a jammy donut. Except I ate it already and my voice is fine. Listen. La, 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 la.
But lemons are sour. And I don't like the smell of garlic.
Carrots turning parsnips.
What's that?
I like carrots.
Carrots turning parsnips.
Well, I think it's Stan.
Carrots turning parsnips. But Stan, he's your man. Get the one who's fresh at Stan.
Oh, wet walruses, what was that?
Apples, bananas, oranges and pears. Stan's the man for fresh fruit and veg.
Oh, have you got jammy donuts?
Hello, everybody.
What's that thing?
It's a loud hailer. It makes my voice loud so that everybody in the village can hear me. I want more customers at my shop. Stan, he's your man. Come to Stan. Make a plan to come to Stan.
It's no good. I cannot work with all this row going on.
Wizadora, I've come to complain in the loudest possible terms. What's all this horrible noise?
Me too.
And I want to say...
Huh?
I said, me too.
Oh, well. Right, well, let's sort them out then. Follow me. I said, follow me. Some people...
Stan, he's your man. Come to Stan. Come to Stan for your vegetables, fresh apples, oranges, bananas and pears. Come to Stan for anything you want to wear. Stan, he's your man. Come to Stan for... Actually, hello, is that for me?
Come to Stan with your best.
Oh, first time Tatty's done something right.
Yeah, that shuts Stan up.
Yeah.
Stan, what's all the noise about?
Hello, Wizadora. How's it? Oh, sorry. Sorry.
You were being ever so loud.
Well, that's what these are for.
Well, yes, I know that, but I'm sure everyone could hear you for miles.
Well, I hope so. Anyway, must be on my way. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Come to Stan. Stan.
Wizadora, could you magic up one of those loud hailers for Tatty? Because he's lost his voice.
I'm afraid, Philbert, that loud hailers and magic don't really mix very well. I tell you what, though. Poot and I could teach you how to make your very own. Come on. You could make a paper loud hailer with a piece of stiff paper. Just twist it into a cone shape and tape it along the edge.
Ooh.
And then you talk into the thin end like this and your voice gets louder. Hello out there.
It works! Hooray!
Hello, Philbert!
Hooray!
Thanks, Hilbert.
My, what a clever gadget.
But I must say, I did try sargling with goat water. I mean, gargling with salt water to the old fish, as you suggested, and it did my voice a lot of good.
Right, lads. We've had enough of being helpful. Yes. Let's make mischief. For one, two, 17, three, 43. Four.
Hit it!
Loud is louder.
And loud is louder. Scream and shout, yeah, evil round you.
Learn, play soft, and tap like mouses. Whisper tiny voices. Then bang
and crush and go berserk.
Play the trumpet. Ring, ring.
Hello? Yes? Could you speak up, please? Oh, I see. It's postponed till next week. All right, I'll tell her. Wizadora, your exam isn't today. After all, it's next week.
Oh, gosh.
Right, I've had enough of this. Draw people, you deserve a zap. And I deserve a nap. Night-night, everyone.
We adore her. We adore her. Doing things in her very special way. We adore her. Nothing surer. You're the one that can brighten up our day. Living with your most peculiar friends in a kitchen full of fun. Hoping each day ever ends. We adore her. We adore her. You're the one that can brighten up our day.
Tomorrow.
Did someone speak?
It's our feathered friends in Jay's World, after which we're off to Bottle Bay.
Oh, no. I don't believe my eyes.
Neither does Dinko. It's Astro Farm. Next.
Fever, fever, fever.
Dance Mania 4 with the massive Entrance exclusive. Get the fever. Get Dance Mania 4.
He didn't.
He did.
Oh, he did.
He did, you know.
Oh, he didn't.
He did. I saw it.
What with the...
Oh, I... Oh.
She's been at that ski fruit light.
Fresh, fruity, and virtually fat-free. No taste lifts you like ski fruit light. Get the ski lift.
Oh, he didn't.
He did.
Daisy Flash.
Now, who's been a good boy then?
I have. I did all the shopping.
Okay, new trick for you.
It's gone. That's magic.
Darling, do you fancy a cuppa?
I'm not having any. Look, you always do this. Listen, it won't work. Wow, if you put it like that.
Cadbury's Dairy Milk, the great taste of a glass and a half of fresh, creamy milk in every half pound.
Down, boy.
It's time now for a look at just some of today's action in just a tick. Don't faint, but do fasten your seatbelts. We're off to Astro Farm. Garfield pops up with a fiery fairy tale, Odilocks and the three cats. And then the evil Marmagora has something particularly nasty planned for Phantom Cat. Now, though, hold on tight.
When you're cruising through the cosmos, you won't believe your eyes. There's always something new to see. When you're gliding through the galaxy, there's always a surprise. So why don't you fly with me?
Get it! Good morning, Splodge.
What's good about it? What for breakfast?
You've got to guess, Splodge, but I'll give you a clue. Okay.
Oh, he's gone completely mad this time.
Here you are, Splodge, but watch out, it might be a bit hot.
Yuck! Slime curd porridge! It's hot!
I said it might be hot.
What do you think of this? Doesn't it look magnificent?
You have to give a tiger plant just the right amount of water, not too much wind, just the right amount of sunshine, and just the right amount of plant food. Then you get a plant as magnificent as this one.
You must have found a hard bit, Splodge.
Hard bit? Porridge doesn't have hard bits. Oh, ow!
You've got a toothache, haven't you, Splodge?
You'd have toothache too if all you had to eat was slime curd.
I eat slime curd too, Splodge, but I don't get toothache because I brush my teeth every morning and every night with my little toothbrush, like a good gorp should.
I've got a toothbrush too.
Perhaps I should have a look at your teeth, Splodge.
Oh, all right.
Open wide. You've got a bad tooth, Splodge. That tooth will have to go.
Oh, my back. I'm not sure digging is the best way to start the day. Hello. What's this?
Oh, well, I can't stand about here all day chatting. I've got things to do. Ta-ta.
Bye, Dad.
see that, Dink? I could have
sworn. Oh, no.
Mum, it's Dad's favourite tiger plant. He'll never talk to us again.
Oh, dear.
This way, Splodge.
All right, I'm coming. What do you think you're doing, Pip? Ow!
You'll see, Splodge. All I have to do now is push the table over the edge of the cliff and then out pops the tooth.
But, Pip, if the tooth doesn't pop out, I might get pulled over the...
Oh, dear. What are we going to do, Mum? There's only one thing to do, Tom. I'll have to go to the jungle planet and get another one.
But won't Dad notice it's gone?
Yes. So you'll have to stop him from coming into the farmhouse.
Good luck, Mum.
OK, Tom. See you later.
Hi, Dad.
Oh, hello, Tom.
What you making, Dad?
Well, it's a box for my tools. Anyway, I was going to stop now and make a cup of tea.
Oh, no. Don't worry, Dad. I'll make it. You stay here and rest your feet.
Sorry about that, Splodge. You shouldn't have moved.
Ow, my toe still hurts.
I've got it, Splodge. Let's go down to Astro Farm. They're bound to have something for pulling out bad teeth. Go, go, go.
There you are.
Thanks, Tom. Oh, there's no biscuits. I always have a biscuit this time of morning. I'll get them.
No! Don't worry, Dad. I'll go.
I don't know what's got into Tom. Perhaps he's up to something. I'd better have a look.
Dad! Here's the biscuits. No need to go into the farmhouse or anything.
I think I'll just pop in and have a look at my plant.
Oh, what's up with Dinkle, Dad?
I'm not sure. We'd best stay here and keep an eye on him.
Look, Splodge, there might be something in here that would do it.
Hello, Lizzie. Where have you been?
Oh, hello, Sam. I had to make a quick trip to the jungle planet to get some bananas.
Would you like a cup of tea? I was just going to make one.
No. In fact, I saw some clucks loose in Daisy's field. Perhaps you should go and find them.
Oh, you're right. I better investigate.
Ooh, that was close. Quick, help me to get the tiger plant into the farmhouse before Sam gets back.
The coast is clear, Splodge, and I know just the thing for pulling out that bad, bad tooth.
Can I look down, Pip?
Okay, Splodge! 1, 2, 3!
Pip! No!
That sounds like the gorps. What are they up to?
Look, Splodge! It worked! Come on, Splodge!
There weren't any clucks in Daisy's field. I've been on a wild cluck chase.
Oh, well, how about supper?
OK, I'll just go and say hello to my tiger plant first. What's happened to my plant?
What do you mean?
This is a blue tiger plant. Mine's a yellow one. Is this why you've been trying to keep me out of the house, Tom?
It was me, Sam.
You?
Yes. I'm sorry. It was an accident. I pulled up a root outside and suddenly...
Oh, it's all right,
Lizzie. I don't rooted your tiger.
I'm sure I'll grow to like it.
I'll make it up to you. I thought I could help you to look after it.
Oh, now, that's a very good idea. But let me tell you a few things you have to remember about looking after a tiger plant. Now, you have to remember just to give it the right amount of water. Not too much, not too little.
I did it, Splodge! I pulled out your bad tooth! I bet you feel much better now, don't you?
No, I feel 100 times worse.
That's funny. Let's have a look. Open wide. Oh, dear.
What you mean, oh, dear?
I think I might have, just by accident, Tess, sort of pulled out the wrong tooth.
The wrong tooth? You mean to tell me you pulled out a perfectly good tooth and I've still got my bad tooth? Oh!
Sorry, Splodge. I've still got your tooth, Splodge. You could put it under your pillow and make a wish.
Oh, that's a good idea. I wish I don't see my brother for a whole week.
No, Splodge. No, no, no. Don't be silly. No, Splodge. Oh, bye, Splodge.
Next time I have a toothache, I'll go straight.
When the class
was
half
past three.
CITV.
It's the place to be weekday afternoons. 3:30 means CITV.
For all your very favourite friends, there's only one place to be. CITV.
So I said to her, look here, Bloodwin. If that's your attitude, did you fetch your old cuttlefish? Anyway, shush now, David. It's time to watch Alphabet Castle, look you.
Oh, it's full of letters.
Oh, it's a lucky dip. Oh, Hickory. Let's dip.
Oh, I've got a letter H.
And I've got a letter I. You know what that means? It's... Alphabet Castle.
Is it a castle in the air? No, it's a castle here and there. Flags are flying, plain to see. Alphabet Castle, A, B, C. With old King Alpha and young Queen Bet, and flags are flying, the alphabet. Alphabet Castle, Alphabet Castle, Alphabet Castle, A, B, C.
And today's first letter is H, which sounds like the huh that begins...
Hooray! Now, this is a picture of my great-grandfather. He was king of the castle many years ago. You know, he was always shouting, hooray, hooray! Which was why he was called Hooray Henry. King Hooray Henry. Hooray!
Oh, Alpha, look. Ooh, we've been given some more baby clothes.
Hooray, hooray, hooray!
Yes, hooray, Henry. I'm pleased about that, too. I'll just put them away in the cupboard.
Good idea.
Well, at least when the baby arrives, we won't be needing any more baby clothes.
Now, if our baby is a boy, well, I hope he won't take after Hooray Henry and be shouting,
hooray!
All the time. And I hope he won't take after Harry the Hairy either. Oh, dear me. Or Herbert the Headstrong. Or Hugo the Half-Hearted. You know, he could never make his mind up. He always did everything by halves.
I declare today to be a holiday. Or do I mean a half holiday?
You see, when he did a jigsaw, he only ever half finished it. And when he said a nursery rhyme, well, he only ever half said that.
The grand old he had, he marched them, and...
I know the other half. I know the other half.
Well, excellent gobbledygook. You can help out. Now, the grand old...
York of Duke.
He had...
10,000.
He marched them...
up to the hop of a till.
And...
he darts the mound again.
Thank you for that. Do you know any others?
Old Mother Cupboard went to the hubbard to fetch her poor bog down. But when she got there, the bubbard was cared, so the poor nog had done.
Old Mother Hubbard went to the cupboard to fetch her poor dog a bone. But when she got there...
Oh! Arthur Robin, I do declare, no wonder the cupboard is gone!
Hurry, 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 Hubbard. Click, click, clickety-clack. The sooner you get there, the sooner you'll be back. Click, 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 clickety-clack. Click, click, clickety-clack. Oh, Mother Hubbard went to the baker's to fetch her poor dog a bun. But when she got there...
Ooh, Father Robin, I do declare, no wonder the cupboard is bare! Oh.
Hurry, 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 Hubbard. Oh, click, click, clickety-clack. The sooner you get there, the sooner you'll be back. Click, 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 clickety-clack. Click, click, clickety-clack. Oh, Mother Hubbard went to the sweet shop to fetch her poor dog a lolly. But when she got there...
Ooh, Father Robert, I do declare, no wonder the sweet shop is
hurry,
there!
Hurry, 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 Hubbard. Click, click, clickety-clack. The sooner you get there, the sooner you'll be back. Oh, click, 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 clickety-clack. Click, click, clickety-clack. Oh, Mother Hubbard went to the dairy to fetch her poor dog some cheese. But when she got there...
Ooh, hickory dickory, I do declare no one of them cupboard is bare.
Hurry, 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 Hubbard. Click, click, clickety-clack.
Oh, you have had enough of this. Oh, please, please, run up some more letters.
Oh. And the next letter is I, which sounds like the I that begins...
Impatient, that's me. You know, I can't wait to see what's going on down in Alphabet Street. I'm that impatient.
Alphabet Street.
In Alphabet Street.
In Alphabet Street.
In Alphabet Street.
There are so many people you can meet.
How'd you do?
How'd you do?
How'd you do?
How'd you do?
Their names go from A to Z.
From A to Z.
And on their doors are the letters of the alphabet.
How'd you do?
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 In the garden of the house with the letter I on the door lived a very interesting, impossible, impatient spider called Incy Wincy.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Just counting my legs to see if they're all still here.
Incy Wincy was probably the most impatient spider in the whole of spiderdom.
Well, I must say, ever since I got washed down the spout with the rains, patience has not been one of my virtues.
Incy Wincy was so impatient, he couldn't be bothered to spin a web.
Oh, dear. Oh, no. Fiddlesticks.
And so he caught nothing and went hungry. But Munchy Wunchy had no such problem. She caught loads of things.
Oh, a bouncy bar! La 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 ba. Ooh, you, oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. Ba 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 ba. A delicious tea! Mmm! Dynamite!
Mm. And then what happened?
And then what happened?
Oh, and then?
What happened? I caught the whole alphabet.
Is it a castle in the air? No, it's a castle here and there. Flags are flying, plain to see. Alphabet castle A, B, C. Alphabet castle.
Alphabet Castle. Alphabet Castle, A, B, C.
CITV, it's magic!
Who's the champion tiddlywinker? Find out next.
Ta-da! Angelica, Chucky, Spike, and Tommy! They're crazy, they're Rugrats, they're Pencil Tops! They're free with Kellogg's Rice Krispies, Ricicles, and Banana Bubbles!
You're very keen to come here. And what are you wearing?
They have this fantastic new pizza.
What, in a Pizza Hut?
No, really, it's called a stuffed crust. It's got this ring of cheese inside a thinner crust. Fantastic.
Try eating your crust first.
I've got a Ferrari.
Introducing the stuffed crust pizza from Pizza Hut.
Have you finished with that?
Yes, if he's not careful.
Stuffed crust. What? It'll turn around the way you look at pizza.
FIFA, FIFA, FIFA.
Dance Mania 4 with the massive Entrance exclusive. Get the FIFA. Get Dance Mania 4.
This time, I'm sure you'll never guess what's new inside Kinder Surprise. Oh!
Happy Hippos Holiday! Happy Hippos Holiday!
Among the new surprises!
You'll be finding us!
Oh, no, no! It's a secret! But you might just find them among the many new surprises in Kinder Surprise!
Fisher-Price knows kids will be kids, so the Fisher-Price tape recorder with sing-along microphone is built to take the rough with the tumble.
Spooks! Yes! Spooks!
When you're looking for a spook, there's only one place to find them, and that's on CITV, every Friday afternoon.
Spooks come out on a full moon!
That's right, so don't miss them. The Spooks of Buckle Bay, Fridays 20 to 4, CITV.
Now that's spooky.
Now there's something strange happening to Filbert's tiddlywinks today. I smell wizzification. Hurry along, Cheesy. Don't want to miss the start, do we? Daft cat.
Wizadora, we adore her. Doing things in her very special way. Wizadora, nothing surer. You're the one that can brighten up our day.
Oh, it's you.
Hello.
Oh, it's lovely here today. I hope it's nice where you are. In fact, it's so nice, we thought we'd play some games outside. I wonder if Daddy wants to join in. Oh. Hello, Daddy.
Wizadora, you didn't half give me a fright.
I'm sorry. What's that?
It's my parrot parcel. No, I mean, carrot castle.
Oh, is that so good?
I'm entering it in this year's carrot castle competition at the vegetable show.
I reckon it'll win.
Well, you know, Wizadora, I've had so much fun making it. I don't think I mind whether I win or lose.
I wish everyone was such a good sport. Oh, and speaking of sports, we thought as it's such a lovely day, we'd like to come out and play in the garden.
Oh, I'd like to join you, Wizadora, but it's allowed to rain. I mean, about to rain.
How do you know?
Nigel's horns. When old snail's horns begin to glow, expect a fall of rain or snow.
Beep! A lot of creatures do seem to know about changes in the weather before they happen, but I've nothing in my files about this sort of behaviour in snails.
Oh, my good friend Nigel is a very special snail, a sort of mystic mollusk. Isn't that right, Nigel?
Well, I don't do anything clever. I just get these funny feelings, like it's going to rain any minute.
He's hardly ever wrong.
But how can that be true? The sky's completely blue.
Ho ho! That's my mollusk.
That's amazing. But you know what this rainy weather means? No outdoor games today.
Oh.
Yeah, we could play indoor games.
Yes, I love rainy day indoor games.
Well, what games shall we play then?
Well, my favourite is see who can eat the most biscuits.
Whoa. I thought that was your favourite outdoor game.
And indoor game.
Yeah, and it's a very good game too.
Nigel was right.
inside, if you like. I'll just finish off my parrot puzzle.
How about Tiddlywinks?
Yes, Tiddlywinks is an indoor game.
Is it a computer game?
No, Sticky, it's not a computer game.
I was playing Tiddlywinks long before computers were even invented.
Really, Hangle?
Oh, yes. To many of you, I am just a humble cloak hanger. But many years ago, I was Clifford T. Hangle, cloak hanger Tiddlywinks champion.
Wow!
Oh, show us how to play, please, Hangle.
Show us how to play, please.
Oh, very well. Wizadora, please put a bowl at the end of the table.
Right. There you are.
Well, first, I put this tiddlywink on the table, and then I press down on the edge with this tiddlywink, like so. There, I seem not to have lost any of my old skill. So, do I have a challenge you?
I challenge you.
And me.
I accept the challenge from both of you. Now, come over here, and each of you take two tiddlywinks. The winner is the one whose tiddlywink flies the furthest.
Right, very old fish. We'll support Filbert.
And we'll support Sticky!
Now, my mum always says, it's not the winning that matters, it's the taking part.
Oh, absolutely.
Oh, yes, Wizadora.
Very true, Wizadora. So may the best draw person win.
I'll be umpire. Ready, steady, press.
Don't worry, Filbert. It takes a while to get the hang of it. Look! Mine's gone right to the end of the table! Yes. Yours does seem to have gone the furthest. Yeah. I've beaten the champ. I'm the greatest. I've beaten the champ.
He's beaten the champ!
I've beaten the champ.
It's a fluke. A complete fluke.
Oi! Who are you calling a fluke, you clod-hopping cloak hanger?
Clod-hopping cloak hanger?
Now stop it. Hangle, I'm surprised at you. What a bad loser you are. And as for you, Sticky, it's a game, remember?
Here, Nigel. You can sometimes see into the future. Do you think I'll win this carrot castle competition?
Well, Tatty, I have this funny feeling that you will win, but you should beware of time flying.
Oh, I've got tots of lime. I mean, lots of time. There are 2 days yet till the vegetable show.
Uh-huh. Ha! I'm going to enjoy beating you again.
In your dreams.
Stop it!
Bet mine'll go as far as that wall.
I bet mine'll go through the wall.
It was his.
No, it wasn't. It was his.
You two, I don't believe you. You're such bad sports. Filbert, I don't think you've had your go yet.
Don't see the point, really. After all, Filbert's is never going to get as far as ours.
Yeah, he might as well not bother.
I think they're right. I can't diddle it that far, Wizadora.
No, Filbert, you must have your go. Ah, here's your tiddlywink.
Oh,
dear, I've dropped it on the floor.
Oh.
Shall we teach Hangle and Sticky a lesson? Wizardy tiddle, wizardy wink, twitch your nose and start to blink. Wizardy whiz, wizardy sprocket, make Filbert's tiddlywink fly like a rocket. There it is, Filbert. I'm sorry, I had a bit of trouble finding it.
It's gone into orbit.
Well, you two can stop arguing now because Filbert has won easily.
How did that happen?
Beep. And I think he also gets the prize for being the best winner and the best loser.
Yes, congratulations, Filbert. You are now the new Tiddlywinks champion.
Yeah, well done, Filbert. You were brilliant.
And what about Teddy's carrot castle?
Oh, don't worry. I can have fun building it all over again.
And he's got lots of time.
Don't you mean I've got pots of time?
Wizadora, we adore her. Doing things in her very special way. Wizadora, nothing surer. You're the one that can brighten up our day. Live. most peculiar friends in a kitchen full of fun. Opening each day never ends. Wizadora, we adore her. You're the one that can brighten up our day.
Fantastic. Well, tomorrow at 3:30, the Riddlers are off on an amazing journey. I hope they don't get wet.
Still raining and drizzling.
And the rain's getting absolutely everywhere in Wizadora. They're both tomorrow, next today. Has Granny Clump finally gone bonkers? Find out in the Story Store.
Ta-da! Angelica, Chucky, Spike, and Tommy! They're crazy, they're Rugrats, they're Pencil Tops! They're free with Kellogg's Rice Krispies, Ricicles, and Banana Bubbles!
If your eggs got to be free-range and soft-boiled, and your bread's got to be whiter than white, it's got to be Hovis. Yes, it's white. Yes, it's Hovis. And yes, it is annoying when that happens.
Hey, P. Remember the good old days? On the farm? Remember your pod? And all the little peas that you grew up with? Don't you miss them? Right, next. Hey, P. Remember the good old...
Nobody makes peas mushy like bachelors.
Discover one of Tot's TV animal friends every fortnight. Part one tells you all about Tot's friend, the hedgehog, with lots of things to play, make, and colour in. And in each issue on cassette, the Tots introduce one of their favourite animal stories.
Darkness crept up on the winter woodland as Spike the hedgehog...
Part one comes with this free Tot's Secret House plastic cassette case. Tot's TV animal friends, out now.
Watch this trick!
Ta-da-da-da-da-da!
It's a kind of magic.
CITV.
It's a kind of magic.
There's no place quite like CITV. Weekday afternoons from 3:30.
Yes, coming up today, right up to the ceiling, in fact, probably the world's daftest elephant. Scooby tries to unravel the House of Mystery, and I feel it my duty to warn you that today is Wolfit Day, so please stand well back to avoid unnecessary mutilation.
And I'll be on the planet Solaris 7, taking part in a new team sport that's connecting up America.
That's bad influence later. Now, though, it's time for the Story Store.
The Story Store, the Story Store. Stories, surprises, and secrets galore, and dreams that come true are waiting for you inside the store.
The Story Store, the Story Store. Wonders are waiting for you to explore. Into the window, open the door.
Into the Story Store.
Granny Clump was all of a twitter because her grandson Sammy was coming to visit her that very afternoon. I'll have a lovely garden party for Sammy today. Oh, but just look at the state of the garden. I'm getting too old to look after things properly these days. The flowers are withered and the swing and the seesaw are both broken. Whatever am I to do? Oh, look. It's Bert the handyman. Yoo-hoo! Bert! The very person I need. Have a little job for you to do. In next to no time, Granny Clump set off for the Story Store, while Bert the handyman began to repair the swing and the seesaw. As Granny approached the Story Store, she saw George and Pip having a little nap in their garden.
Yoo-hoo, George! It's only me!
Oh, how do, Granny Clump? Lovely day.
I just wondered if you had anything in the Story Store that would help me perk up a bit.
Well, now, let me think.
Wait a minute. I know the very thing. A little sip from the water of that pool is just what you need. It's the water of youth. My, my. What a nice taste. It makes you feel all tingly. Oh, how delightful. I'm all light-headed. You'll have to excuse me, Granny Clump. Pip's telling me that there's a customer in the story store. That water was so stimulating that I think I'll just try another teensy-weensy little sip. When George entered the story store, he discovered that his customer was none other than Sammy Clump. Hello, George. I'm going to see my granny this afternoon, and I thought I'd like to buy her a little present. Oh, well, Sammy, it's a small world and no mistake. Your granny's here, you know. She's in the garden. In fact, I think I hear her coming now. Here I come. Whoopee! Hey-ho, fiddle-dee-dee. I bet you custard you can't catch me. She must have drunk too much of the water of youth. She's behaving like a two-year-old. No, Granny, don't do it. Here I come. Yes, Granny. Tickle-ickle-ickle. Upon her from either side. It's all right, George. I'll help you to catch her. I knew that was a flying umbrella. I just knew it. However, will we get her down? Here's something that should do the trick. It's a tin of fly powder. With a little of this sprinkled on us, we can float up to the ceiling ourselves and catch Granny. All right, Sammy. Now.
Yippee!
Oh, no. Oh, fiddle-dee-dee. You owe me a custard. You couldn't catch me. Whatever will she get up to next? When George and Sammy came down to Earth once more, they set off to find the runaway Granny. But no matter where they looked, they couldn't find her. Yoo-hoo! 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 Right, lads, jump.
Yoo-hoo! Hold your boys. That's for you, George.
What does Granny's note say, George?
I think I'll just have another tiny sip of that lovely magic water.
It says, "That's another custard you owe me, signed G. Clump."
Yippee!
That's that, then. The swing's mended, and so is the seesaw. Oh. It'll take anybody's weight now. Yoo-hoo! It's a banshee. Oh, no, it's not. It's Granny Clump. Oh, lovely. At last to have the garden I've always dreamed of. I can't wait to try out the seesaw. Come on, Bert. Oh, no, I couldn't. We can't stop searching until we find your granny.
And
she's in no condition to be let loose on her own.
Yippee!
What is it, Pip? There's no one there. I can't take another step. My granny's on a seesaw. Nay! Oh! Yeah, well, at least she's out of harm's way there.
Stop it!
I'll have to sit down.
Oh, stop it!
Me too. I'm exhausted.
Oh, no! Give over!
Oh, how wonderful! You've all come to my garden party. I'd have been better off with a banshee. Granny Clump was delighted to have guests at her garden party, even if they did all seem mysteriously tired. She offered them the delicious goodies she'd made earlier, but since none of them seemed hungry, Granny thought the best thing to do was to eat everything up herself. And so Bert and George and Sammy and Pip lay sleeping, hoping in their dreams that when they wakened up, Granny Clump would be her old self once more.
The story store, wonders are waiting for you to explore. Peep through the window, open the door, into the story store. Story surprises and secrets galore.
When the clock says half past three, who do you want to see? CITV! Chase full of the Riddlers, the spooks upon the way. Join them on CITV every thankful day. Wizadora, alphabet, castle, giggly shorts, the stars of TV. Stars and all your favourite friends, there's only one place.
Oh, hello there, Daveth. Fancy seeing you here. Make yourself nice and comfortable, boyo. You're just in time for Alphabet Castle. So be quiet.
Dickory? Dickory?
I think all the pieces are here.
Oh, but there's a piece missing.
Is it a castle in the air? No, it's a castle here and there. Flags are flying, plain to see. Alphabet Castle, A, B, C. With old King Alpha and young Queen Bet. And flags are flying, the alphabet. Alphabet Castle, Alphabet Castle, Alphabet Castle, A, B, C.
And today's letter is J, which sounds like the J that begins. Now, look, oh, the last bit of sky, I think, Bet.
Mm-hmm.
There. Now.
And I found a pail, Alpha. I wonder where that
so
goes.
So you have.
Oh, I think it fits in here.
So it does. And look, here's the head of a boy by the look of things, so he must be... Oh, how confusing. Wait a second.
Oh.
That's where he goes, but he's upside down.
I wonder why.
Search me.
Having a clue.
Well, now here's a girl, so she's probably standing over. No. Oh, look, Alpha, look, she's upside down too.
Oh, and here are the last pieces, but I don't understand.
Oh, I've got it. It's Jack and Jill.
Of course. Look, there's the well, there's the pail, and there's Jack and Jill.
Jack and Jill went up the hill to fetch a pail of water.
Jack fell down
and broke his crown.
And Jill came tumbling after.
Oh, I know that one. Jick and Jill hit up the well to fetch a whale of water. Jack fell down and croaked his brown, and Jill came tumbling after.
Thank you, Gobbledygook.
Don't mention it.
Oh, that's a quite a nice little rhyme. Oh, we thought we'd set it to music on the mouse organ. Are you ready, Hickory? Here we go. One, two, three.
Oh, why don't you all join in the song?
Jack and Jill,
Jack and Jill
went up the hill,
went up the hill
to fetch a pail of water.
Don't splash it.
Jack fell down.
Down.
Shame.
And broke his crown.
Fell and broke his crown.
Oh, what a pain.
And Jill came tumbling after.
And Jill came tumbling after.
And Jill came tumbling after.
Mind out.
And Jill came tumbling after.
After. After.
Duh. What a bump.
Oh, thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Perhaps we should have a change of letter. Oh, good idea. What's the next letter, Dickory?
It's something you can't do without if you want to say king or kite instead of ing or ite. Raise the K.
The letter K, which sounds like the K that begins... King.
Oh, a king walks this way. A king walks that way. With a bit of a swagger and a bit of a sway. He gives commands, he makes demands. Lower the J, raise the K. The king walks this way, the king walks that way. With a bit of a swagger and a bit of a sway. Both far and wide he sought a bride and found Queen Bet, the best bet yet. Oh, a king walks this way, a king walks that way. With a bit of a swagger and a bit of a sway. You know, Betty, when our son grows up, I do not want him to be king of the castle and live here.
Nor I to want my daughter to be queen.
I would like him...
or her...
to go down and live...
in Alphabet Street.
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 There are so many people you can meet.
How'd you do?
How'd you do?
How'd you do?
How'd you do?
Their names go from A to Z.
From A to Z.
And on their doors are the letters of the alphabet.
How'd you do?
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 A kinder man you'll never find than Mr. Kevin. Kevin the kind. He never says don't.
He never says do. But...
do you mind?
He's kind to dogs. He's kind to cats. He's even kind to vampire bats.
Oh. Here, Bumpy.
A kinder man you'll never find than Mr. Kind, Kevin the Kind. A man of few words, he's kind to birds. A kinder man you'll never find. He's kind to ants and spiders too, to beetles and ladybirds, to name but a few. He's kind to frogs, he's kind to toads, helps them over logs and cross the roads. A kinder man you'll never find than Mr. Kind. A missing bit, he makes it fit. To this and that and that.
A finder man you'll never kind than Kister Mevin, Kevin the Kind.
Oi, Kevin, be kind to us too.
Oh, yes. Mm.
Is it a castle in the air? No, it's a castle here and there. Flags are flying, plain to see. Alphabet castle A, B, C. Alphabet castle. Alphabet castle. Alphabet castle A, B, C.
Wizardy knee, we're on next on CITV.
He's been at that ski fruit split.
Bustle be full.
Thick, creamy, and with a chunky fruit mix on the side. No taste lifts you like new ski fruit split. Get the ski lift.
Oh, I missed it.
Rising up with the eye of a tiger.
Nice try.
Took my chances, went the distance. Now I'm back.
Let's break, Tony.
You got it.
Hey, play for the court.
You're on.
When you've had a great game, there's nothing like the great taste of Frosties as part of your nutritious breakfast. Kellogg's Frosties.
They're great!
What are these?
Sores.
What are those?
Hedges. Sores. Hedges.
So what are these?
Walls.
No! Sausages. 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 Sausages.
Thick, meaty sausages are pronounced walls.
Walls. Now you're talking sausages.
Fisher-Price knows kids will be kids, so the Fisher-Price tape recorder with sing-along microphone is built to take the rough with the tumble.
Spooks!
Yes!
Spooks!
When you're looking for a spook, there's only one place to find them, and that's on CITV, every Friday afternoon.
Spooks come out on a full moon.
That's right, so don't miss them. The Spooks of Buckle Bay, Fridays 20 to 4, CITV.
Now that's spooky.
Now then, Albert, what do you think of all the weather we've been having lately? Saying nothing, eh? Probably very wise, because something funny's going on. Perhaps we ought to ask Wiz.
We adore her, we adore her. Doing things in her very special way. Wizadora, nothing surer. You're the one that can brighten up our day.
Oh, I've never been so hot, Wizadora. Can't you do anything?
Why don't you have some pop, Hangle?
I wish I could get into very old fish's tank.
Oh, no, thank you very much, Angle. There's only room for one in this hot water tank.
If only it could be winter again, just for one day.
Frost, snow, ice.
Ice cream?
Yes, that's it. A change of season spell.
I've got the very spell, Wizadora. It's wizardy mop, wizardy fan, a day of winter, that's the plan.
That's the very one. Now, where's my wand?
Oh, it's hot, isn't it?
You're telling me.
So, what about a nice cold drink?
Oh, pleasure. Yes, please, Stan.
Aha! The spell is wizardy mop, wizardy fan, a day of winter, that's the plan. We're too hot, and that's the reason we would like a change of season.
Oh, hurry up, Wizadora. The water in my tank will be boiling any minute.
Oh, well, we can't have that very old fish. You'll be cooked. Right, are you ready, Wand?
Too hot! Too hot!
Well, I can't do it without you, Wand.
Too hot!
It'll soon be cooler. Oh, hello. Will you help me with the spell, please? Wizardy mop, wizardy fan, a day of winter, that's the plan. We're too hot, and that's the reason we would like a change of season.
Has it worked?
I don't know. Can you notice anything different?
Oh, yes, I'm feeling hungrier already.
Oh, it's getting cooler every minute.
Am I a wizard, or am I a wizard?
Oh, I think I'll move away from this window, though. It's getting very cold now. Ooh.
It is rather chilly. Perhaps I'll put a scarf on.
Oh, dear. I hope this spell hasn't worked too well.
It's gone cold. What's happening? It's snowing, but it can't be. It's summer.
Mm. Oh, that's better.
I'm really wheezing. really freezing.
Nothing like a cold drink to cool you down on a hot day.
Well, this must be a really cold drink, Stan. Aren't you freezing?
Yes, now you mention it. Oh, that's strange.
Well, no wonder we're so cold. It's glowing. Snowing.
Snowing? Well, it can't be. It's the middle of summer.
Look at my veggie bubbles. vegetables. They've all turned brown.
I don't believe it.
What's going on?
Magic. That's what this is. Wizardora's magic. You must have brought it in the shop with you.
No, I didn't. Well, I don't think I did.
I'm going to phone Wizardora. I've told her time and time again I won't have any magic in my shop.
Ring, ring. Ring, ring. Oh, Wizardora's residence.
Stand here. Now, what is going on? One minute's a hot summer's day, and now it's snowing. Is this anything to do with Wizardora?
Yes, Stan, we have been having a little trouble here, but Wizardora's doing her best to sort it out. Ooh, goodbye, it's too cold for a long chat.
Ooh. It's getting too cold, even for mischief.
Yes, might as well go in.
Wait for me. Help! Mayday! Help! Oh, Wizardora, the water in my tank is freezing! Help! Icebergs ahead! Mayday!
Oh. Help is on its way! I'll be there in a minute, old fish! I think that spell was a bit too strong, don't you? Ooh.
Here, Wizardora, put these on, otherwise you'll freeze before you find a reversing spell.
Oh, thank you, Hangle. Got to change the season back to summer soon.
Aha! I found the reversing spell, Wizardora. It's wizardy jump, wizardy hop. This winter day has got to stop. Ice and snow must melt away. Bring back summer without delay.
Thanks, Poot. Will you help me with this? Right. Wizardy jump, wizardy hop, this winter day has got to stop. Ice and snow must melt away. Bring back summer without delay.
Has it worked? Check very old fish's tank.
Help! Help! Fish in distress! Mayday! Oh.
Nigel, the lifesaver, coming to the rescue. Don't worry, nearly there.
Well, I don't know if it's my imagination, but it does seem a bit warmer.
It's still not right, though.
Listen to that wind.
And look, all the leaves are falling off the trees.
Oh, no, it's changed to autumn.
What's happening now? The leaves are falling.
Oh, this is really strange weather, Horace.
Yes, Boris. Let's fly somewhere hotter and leaf him to it.
Yeah.
Whoa.
Wizardy brush, wizardy sweep. All those leaves into a heap. Enough of chilly winds and rain. Bring back summer once again.
Well, the wind's gone.
Yes, but it's still a bit chilly.
I give up.
Daffodils? I can't keep up with this. Now it's turned to spring.
I want a word with that Wizadora. Wizadora?
Oh, Stan, hello. I'm afraid we're having a bit of trouble here.
Just as I thought. Wizadora, this magic is too much. All Tatty's vegetables are shriveled up. Now what am I going to sell my customers?
Well, I'm sorry, Stan. You see, we were all so hot.
We asked Wizadora to do a spell to make it winter.
Just for a day?
So we could all cool down.
Oh, it was even too hot to eat.
But things went a bit wrong, I'm afraid.
So, what are you going to do about it?
I'm going to have just one more try.
I think I'd better step outside to keep an eye on the weather.
This time I've got to get it right. Wizardy dance, wizardy sing, la la! We've had enough of silly spring. Wizardy go, wizardy stay, bring back summer without delay.
Well done, Wizadora. Look at the garden.
Oh, thank goodness. We're back where we started.
Wizadora, we adore her. Doing things in her very special way. Wizadora, nothing surer. You're the one that can brighten up our day. Living with your most peculiar friends in a kitchen full of fun. Hoping each day ever ends. Wizadora, we adore her. You're the one that can brighten up our day.
Ah, trust Wiz to lift the clouds. Now, what's on tomorrow?
What are we waiting for? Come on, let's zoom away.
Wizardy sun, wizardy sea. We'll see you tomorrow on CITV.
Well, next today, Granny's going to pieces. But it could be worse. The hippo's cracking up altogether in the story store.
Ta-da! Angelica, Chucky, Spike, and Tommy! They're crazy, they're Rugrats, they're Pencil Tops! They're free with Kellogg's Rice Krispies, Ricicles, and Banana Bubbles!
Discover one of Tots TV animal friends every fortnight. Part one tells you all about Tots' friend the hedgehog, with lots of things to play, make, and colour in. And on cassette, one of the Tots' favourite animal stories. Part one comes with this free plastic cassette case. Tots TV animal friends, out now.
If you're looking for the ultimate crunchy yogurty sensation, Crunch Corner Yogurt from Müller is the perfect combination. On the one hand, it's colossally crisp, crunchy, chocolate-covered flakes of corn. Yet on the other, it's fearsomely smooth, fruit-flavoured yogurt. So it's both creamy and crunchy at the same time. Crunch Corner Yogurt. So colossally creamy, so catastrophically crunchy. From Müller. Who else?
Let's put a flake in this break.
Put a flake in your way.
With Cadbury's Time Out.
Hello, Willie. Say sausages. Come on.
Wolves.
No.
Sausages.
Wolves.
Sausages.
Wolves.
Thick, meaty sausages are pronounced wolves.
He wouldn't say sausages.
Wolves. Now you're talking sausages.
Yes. Look at that!
Just 5 days to go till simply the best CITV hits your screen. Will you be ready? Yes, it's going to be incredible, is that? Coming up today, dust that not only makes you sneeze, it blows you apart.
My, my.
Over here.
Yes, they're back with a vengeance and a virtuoso performance, the Animaniacs. Of course, we all know the penalty for missing Wolfit. You have been warned.
On Bad Influence today, how to become very, very rich and very, very famous by inventing a new game.
Now, here's the story store.
Story store, the story store. Stories, surprises and secrets galore. And dreams that come true are waiting for you. Inside the store.
The story store. The story store. Wonders are waiting for you to explore. Into the window, open the door.
Into the story store.
It was a lovely summer day, but Granny Clump couldn't feel the benefit of it. She had other things on her mind.
I'm getting too old to look after things properly these days.
As you well know, Bert, I very seldom mention the agonies I endure from my bunions. I prefer to suffer in silence, but I will tell you this. My bunions are throbbing now as they have never throbbed before. And do you know what I blame?
No, I don't.
I blame the state of that fence. What's a broken fence got to do with bunions? That fence upsets me, Bert. Until that fence is mended, I'll be all of a twitter and umply-pumply-dumplified. And when I'm upset like that, it goes straight to my bunions. Just you leave that to me, Granny Clump. I'll just go back to my yard for my tools and pushcart, and I'll be back to mend your fence in a jiffy. Now, Sammy, while Bert's doing that, I want you to go to the story store and ask George for a box of bunion balm. I can't stand this throb, throb, throbbing another moment. All right, Bert, don't worry about your pushcart being broken. I'll be over in 2 ticks with a new one from the story store. I won't be long, Pip, but while I'm gone, I want you to look after the story store for me. Can you do that? Oh, hello, George. I was just on my way to see you. My granny wondered if you had a box of bunion balm. I'm sure we have one in the story store, Sammy. People show you where it is. Sorry, I can't stop. I'm just delivering this pushcart to Bert. Bye-bye. These boxes all look so alike. I wonder which one is the bunion balm. I think this might be it, but the label's torn. Is that the bunion balm, Pip? Good. Well, I'd better hurry back to my granny with it. I can almost feel her bunions throbbing from here. Oh, I'm all of a doodah. What can be taking Sammy so long? Ah, here he comes now. I've got the bunion balm, Granny. It says on the box, shake to activate. Will I try it out for you now? Oh, yes, please. I can't bear to wait another moment. Oh, what was that? Oh, help! What's happening to me? Wow, how did that happen? Oh, no! What's going on? This is dreadful. I don't know whether I'm coming or going. Help! Help! Sammy, do something quick! Go and fetch George and get him to come here and put me back together again.
Back at the story store, Pip was feeling lonely and bored.
So graceful and light on my feet. Ah!
Dear, look at what I've done now. Oh, hello, Victoria. You haven't seen my granny's bottom half going this way, have you?
Yes, I have, Sammy. It gave me such a fright. Whatever is going on? I don't know. It must be something I did with the bunion balm box here. Ah! What's happened? I can't stop bouncing up and down. Oh, no, it's gone wrong again. Whatever shall I do now? You see, that's the marvellous thing about this pushcart, Bert. You don't have to push it at all. When you move this lever, it will go anywhere you want it to. My, my. Whatever next? How do, Granny Clump? Lovely day? Oh, is that you, Granny Clump? Well, that's funny. There is no sign of her. And here's another wonderful thing about this pushcart, Bert. It's multi-speed. It can go slow, like that, or fast, like that, and it can stop in an instant, like that. But you must be very careful to point the control at the cart. If you point it anywhere else, you might do someone a mischief. I've never seen anything like it in my life. Oh, quick, George, quick. You'll have to do something. My granny's bottom half has run away and Victoria Pumpkin's having convulsions. Why? What's happened? I think it was something I did with this bunion balm box. That's not a bunion balm box. That's for separating and whisking eggs. You must have separated your granny and whisked Victoria with it. Here, hold that while I take a look at it. But as George was examining the egg separator, Sammy was examining the pushcart control. And without meaning to, he moved the lever while pointing the control at George and Bert. Oh, no. What?
Something, but who could have done it? It's that house in Ring.
When the clock was on the screen,
3:30.
Who do you want to see? CITV.
Hello, yes, it's 3:30 and time for Rustman to headbutt the wall. Beautifully done, sir. Well, while he's recovering from that, we can sit back, relax, and watch the Riddlers.
They'll turn up all right, Miss Dorr. You'll see.
Oh, I wish I could believe you, Mr. Grimley. It's been a week now, and there's no sign of them. You don't suppose they've gone away for good, do you?
No, of course not.
But where can they have got to?
Oh, maybe that's them now.
Oh, no, just the post. Mr. Grimley! It's from them. They've sent me a postcard.
What does it say?
Dear Marjorie, we're sorry we went away without telling you, but you weren't there when we left. Please don't worry. We're perfectly safe and having a lovely time. Love from Mossop, Tidlop, Midler and Glossop. You'll never guess where they are.
Where?
In France.
France? What earth are they doing there?
Having a lovely time by the sound of it.
I don't want to go to school again. I mean, it's bad enough having Riddler lessons with you at home. I didn't come to France just to go to lessons again, and in a language I don't even understand.
But you're not going to have lessons. We're just going to have a look around and see what a French school is like.
Oh, you mean you promise we're not going to have riddling lessons?
Of course I do.
Oh, I don't mind then. Could be quite fun.
I'm sure it will be, and I think it'll be really interesting as well. Yeah. And it's kind of Monsieur used to arrange it.
Yeah.
Oh, look, he's waiting for us.
Alors, le voyage de Monsieur Rius, Maxime.
7h58.
Voilà.
Whoa, they're really clever, these children, aren't they?
What do you mean?
Well, they're so young, but they all speak French perfectly.
I mean, of course they speak French perfectly. They are French. They're brought up to speak it, just like we're brought up to speak English.
Oh, I wish I could speak French. Then I'd understand what this lesson was all about.
I expect these children wish they could speak English. Then they'd know what we were saying. Monsieur Rius, can any of the children speak English?
Yes, they speak English.
Do they speak English as well as you do?
What's better?
Better? Corin, they're so young. Well, I could have a word with them after the lesson.
Hey, do you two speak English?
Yes.
Oh, what are you doing in a French school then?
Because my parents moved here 3 years ago.
Did they? Okay. And you've been coming to classes ever since then?
Yes.
Is it difficult following the lessons then? That's very clever.
Perhaps you could teach us to speak French a bit. It's playtime now, isn't it? What's the French for play?
Jouer.
Jouer.
What are we waiting for? Come on, let's jouer!
Well, Glossop, you can really tell you're in a foreign country. When you hear them, their songs they're singing. They sound really jolly, but I haven't got the faintest idea what they're about.
Yeah, but it doesn't matter though, does it, little brother? You can still enjoy listening to them, even if you don't understand what they're about. Mm. And you can tell the children are enjoying singing them.
They might live in different countries and speak different languages, but children are the same the whole world over. By heck, they are the same the world over. Little perishers, the lot of them. Oh, you! I know you don't understand what I'm saying, but watch it! Do you hear? Watch it! Are we all going round the market on our own, then?
You're not, Midler. You're far too young.
Oh.
You can come round with me. But Mossop and Tidlock want to do a bit of shopping on their own.
They'll not be able to do any shopping. They can't speak French. None of us can speak French apart from you.
Then it's time you all learned a few words. Now, those English children at that there school managed to learn French, didn't they? So, you don't need to know a lot, but it's important to be able to say please and thank you.
Oui means yes, and no means no. Say bonjour when you mean hello. Don't say please, say s'il vous plaît.
S'il vous plaît.
Merci is thanks, and that's all you need to say. Again, oui means yes,
yes,
and no means no. Say bonjour when you mean hello.
Bonjour.
Don't say please, say s'il vous plaît.
S'il vous plaît.
Merci is thanks, and that's all you need to say. All together,
oui
means
yes,
no means
no.
Say bonjour when you mean
hello. Hello.
That's right. Don't say please, say
s'il vous plaît.
Very good. Merci is thanks, and that's all you need to say.
Right.
Now, here are some francs.
Francs what? Who is this franc when he's at home, anyway?
It's French money, little brother. In Britain, we have pounds. In France, they have francs. It's different from our money. Oh, and one last thing. If you don't know the name of the thing you want to buy, and I'm sure you won't know, Then just point to it and say, Je voudrais cela, s'il vous plaît. It means, right. I'd like that, please.
OK.
Got that?
Gosh, that cheese looks good. I wonder if I dare try to buy some. What was the French for hello? Bonjour.
Bonjour.
Il voudrait cela, s'il vous plaît.
Du roquefort.
Yes. I mean, oui.
Un petit morceau.
Oui.
Whoa. Oh, it all looks so good, doesn't it? Yeah. What? Hey, what are they?
They're little melons, they are.
Huh?
Have you ever tried one?
Tried one? I've never even seen one before.
Oh. Here.
Huh?
Go and buy one.
Hello. I mean, bonjour.
Bonjour.
Je voudrais cela, s'il vous plaît.
Oui. Et voilà quatre. Quatre mots. La France, s'il vous plaît. Merci.
It works! It works!
Well done. Yeah.
It was easy. I just pointed to it and said, Je voudrais cela, s'il vous plaît. Just like Glossop told me, and the man understood me.
I know. I bought some cheese like that as well. I wonder if Mossop bought anything.
Oh, very nice, little brother. Very nice. Did you really mean to buy that, eh?
No, I didn't.
Then you should have paid more attention to when I was teaching you to speak French,
There was nothing wrong with my French, Glossop. I pointed and said, Je voudrais cela, s'il vous plaît, just like you told me. Mm-hmm. Only problem is, I happened to be pointing at this when I said it.
Wiz receives a magical present. Next.
Well, do you notice anything different tonight?
Yeah, these butterfly cakes taste great.
Get your baking noticed again with the butter-like taste of New Stork Rich Blend.
Your cat couldn't be in better hands.
Nestle Cheerios, multi-grain nutrition. Never.
Tasted so good.
Nestle Cheerios, the goodness of corn, oats, rice and wheat in deliciously light crispy O's. When you try them, you'll say...
Multi-grain.
Nutrition.
Never tasted.
So good.
Oh,
or if you don't agree, we'll give you your money back.
Discover one of Tots TV animal friends every fortnight. Part one tells you all about Tots' friend the hedgehog, with lots of things to play, make and colour in. And on cassette, one of the Tots' favourite animal stories. Part one comes with this free plastic cassette case. Tots TV animal friends, out now.
There's so much fun for you to enjoy every Friday afternoon on CITV when you tune in for stories, poems, songs and much more. Jay's World, Friday, 3:30, CITV.
This is one of Jay's biggest fans, aren't you, Abbercat?
Meow.
Yes, in fact, he told me he loves Jay so much he could eat him. Here, just a minute, what do you mean, eat him?
We adore her, we adore her. Doing things in her very special way. Wizadora, nothing surer. You're the one that can brighten up our day.
Hey, I've won!
you didn't, Top. Sticky one.
Ha! Told you so.
You've been playing computer games for ages. If you keep staring at that screen, you'll hurt your eyes. Why don't you go and play something else?
But I haven't had my turn yet.
Oh, hello, it's you. I thought I'd make some ginger biscuits, but I need the recipe from Poot. Poot, a ginger biscuit recipe, please.
I won't again.
Will you go and play something else?
But I haven't even started.
Yes, but I need the recipe for ginger biscuits from Poot.
Biscuits?
Don't someone say biscuits?
Ginger biscuits?
Yes, if I find the recipe. Poot has it stored on her computer files, haven't you, Poot?
Beep. Sticky is the winner with 30,000 points.
Oh, no. She's stuck in her game mode.
Ring, ring. Hello, Wizadora's residence. Phoebe speaking. How may I help you? Oh, Wizadora, your mother says she'll fax you her ginger biscuit recipe. Oh, and your mother says there's a present on its way. But it's important...
Oh, Top! That was really rude. You're certainly not getting any ginger biscuits. I wonder what Mum was going to say when Top cut her off.
Beep! Fax message coming in, Wizadora.
Oh, good. That'll be my recipe. Maybe that's the present Mum said she was sending. What is it?
I am a magic pastry cutter in the shape of a star. At your service, Wizadora.
Brilliant! I can cut my biscuits into star shapes now.
I am a circle pastry cutter. I'll make a round biscuit for you.
Even better!
I like star-shaped biscuits the best.
I am a square pastry cutter. I cut good shapes and no messing about.
Oh, well, I'm sure your square biscuits will taste equally as delicious.
And I am a cross cutter.
Oh, I don't mind him. He is always in a bad mood.
Now then, you lazy cutters, get into line. Look lively, look lively. Wait for it, wait for it. Go! Allez, allez!
What a wizard present! Now, all I've got to do is wait for the cutters to cut out the biscuit shapes, and then I'll put the biscuits into the oven.
Ring, ring! Oh, hello? Oh, Wizadora, it's your mother. Now, she says it's very important to...
Sticky, that was very naughty.
Hello, Tatty.
I can't understand it. I really can't. I planted both those plants on the same day, yet that one's grown very tall, and that one's still very short.
I don't know about your plants, Tatty, but I know I got lots of parcels of different shapes and sizes to deliver today, and it's hard work.
Well, where's your bicycle?
I cycled it over a rut and both wheels fell off.
The wheels fell off your bicycle?
Both of them, and rolled away.
I'll make you some new ones.
Oh, would you, Tatty? That would be lovely.
I'll start straight away.
And I'd better get on delivering. I got a parcel for Wizadora.
Yoo-hoo, Wizadora, are you there?
Hello, Pippa. You look a bit tired.
I am. I've got so many parcels to deliver. There's one for you in here somewhere. Oh. They're all such funny shapes. There's this oval-shaped one and this round one and a... Oh, I think yours is right at the bottom.
I'll tell you what, Pippa. I'll help you deliver those parcels, and then we can come back and have some tea. I've just made some lovely ginger biscuits. I brought them out to cool.
Ginger biscuits? They're my favourite.
Mine too, especially the star-shaped ones.
Ready?
Hey, Sticky!
Yes, boss?
Wizadora's gone out and left all those lovely biscuits to cool. All brown and mouth-watering they are.
Cool. Lovely shapes, aren't they?
Yes. And going cold, it seems such a waste.
Oh, is it my turn to play computer games yet?
Bottom, there are more important things in life than playing computer games.
Yeah, like biscuits.
Biscuits?
Yeah, I fancy a star-shaped one.
I'd like a round one with a hole in the middle.
There aren't any round ones with holes in the middle.
Oh, aren't there? Isn't that Wizadora's wand?
Quiet Bottom!
Yes, Quiet Bottom!
Yeah, Quiet Bottom! Oh, sorry.
My head!
Action stations, look sharp, form into line.
What's happening? Oh, help!
Whoa, take cover, me laddos!
Oh, this is better than pastry.
Oh, help! Get me out of here!
Oh, isn't this fun?
Help, Wizadora! Help!
Did someone call?
Oh, I wish I could travel that fast normally.
Beep! Your mother called, Wizadora. Message timed at 15:40 precisely. She said the pastry cutters need careful handling.
Ah, so that's what she was trying to tell me when Sticky cut her off.
Help! Wizadora, please!
Right, pastry cutters, into a line. Now, get into the sink to be washed up.
At once, Wizadora. Cutters at the double now. Quick march. 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2.
Oh, thank you, Wizadora. I'll never take your wand again or steal any biscuits.
Well, that'll teach you.
Your parcel's the very last one, Wizadora.
Ooh. I've mended your bike, sir. I thought square wheels might make you go faster, but they don't seem to want to go round.
That's because they're not round, Tatty. You made one square and one triangular.
Oh, yeah.
I think this calls for a bit of wizification. Are you ready, wand? Will you help us with this? Pippa wants to be homeward bound. Make her bicycle wheels turn round. Got that? Right, let's do it. Pippa wants to be homeward bound. Make her bicycle wheels turn round.
Ooh, well done.
Thank you, Wizadora.
You forgot to open your parcel.
Oh, yes, so I have. Wonder what it is. This is exciting. Oh, brilliant. It's a game. Look, these shapes match my biscuits. Which reminds me. Come on, everyone.
Wizadora, we adore her. Doing things in her very special way. Wizadora, nothing surer. You're the one that can brighten up our day. Living with your most peculiar friends in a kitchen full of fun. Hoping each day ever ends. Wizadora. We adore her. You're the one that can brighten up our day.
Tomorrow.
Can't you see I'm trying to choose my lunch?
That's a good idea.
And the spooks are having a night out. Please do not adjust your television. We're having atmospheric problems on Astro Farm. Next.
How does CoverGirl Helena Christensen magnify her lashes without clumps or globs? With new professional mascara, the new formula glides on with a special curved brush to magnify every lash without clumps or globs. For lashes that look natural, new professional mascara from the new look of CoverGirl.
Start the day the wrong way and hunger might catch up with you.
Ha-ha! Hunger strikes!
But start with Shreddies, and each one is packed with layer upon layer of whole wheat that keeps hunger locked up till lunch. Now Shreddies with stackers free inside.
Discover one of Tots TV animal friends every fortnight. Part one tells you all about Tots friend the hedgehog, with lots of things to play, make and colour in. And on cassette, one of the Tots favourite animal stories. Part one comes with this free plastic cassette case. Tots TV animal friends, out now.
Fisher-Price knows kids will be kids, so the Fisher-Price tape recorder with sing-along microphone is built to take the rough with the tumble.
Excuse me, sir. I wonder if you could tell us what staggering, tongue-tickling change lies beneath the thick chocolate of new club biscuits. The new Jacob's Club. Everyone's talking about what's changed beneath that thick chocolate.
Coming up this afternoon, what lives on the strange dark moon hovering over Astro Farm? Find out next. Well, Garfield's having trouble getting to sleep this week. Yes, can't imagine why, though. A phantom cat faces the evil mind leech. And will Rex ever see his bike again? That's Woof. Now, though, yes, it's time.
When you're cruising through the cosmos, you won't believe your eyes. There's always something new to see. When you're gliding through the galaxy, there's always a surprise. So why don't you fly with me?
There are a lot of hungry mouths to feed around here.
Beaks, you mean? Uh-oh, this basket's empty. Come on, Dink, let's get another one from the barn. Mine's nearly empty.
I've run out too.
Come on, Tom. The clucks are waiting for their food.
I can't find any more food, Mum. We've looked everywhere.
We had a delivery yesterday, but I haven't had time to check it yet.
Oh, no. It's moo cake. The clucks can't eat this. Why can't they eat what we eat?
No, it's no good, Tom. They can only eat cluck food.
But they're all my friends. We must find them something to eat. Come on, Dink.
Poor Tom. He's really attached to the clucks.
We're all attached to them, but if we don't get them something to eat, they'll starve.
That was a good jump, Freddy. Oops! Flora, you dropped the club.
What you got there?
Nothing, Splodge.
There must be something. You were talking to it.
No, I wasn't.
Yes, you were.
Was it?
Were. Anyway, I don't care about your crummy books. I've got much better things to do. Oh! That's funny. I've never seen anything like that before.
What is it, Splodge?
Why should I tell you? You won't tell me what you've got in your box? Very, very interesting.
Oh, come on, girls. You've got to eat something. Here you are, Clementine. Try this.
Any luck, Tom?
No, Mum. We've tried them with just about everything that grows on Astro Farm, but they're not interested.
Oh. That's odd.
What is?
Up there. It looks like a shooting star. But I'm not sure.
I'd better check it on the computer. I'm not sure it is a shooting star, Sam.
Nor am I.
Look, it's getting bigger and bigger. I think it's headed this way.
It's going too fast. I think it's going to hit us.
Look out, Biff. It's coming straight for us.
What is, Splodge?
Duck!
A duck? Are you sure, Splodge? That was a very big duck, Splodge. Splodge? Splodge?
It just missed us. Are you all right, Tom?
Yes, Mum. What was it?
Look, up there. We've got a new moon.
Look, there's something flying towards us.
It landed just over there.
on, Dink. Let's go and see. Be careful, Tom.
Splodge! Splodger!
Get off me, you great gore! Oh, that was close. That's funny. It looks like a moon. What's that doing here?
Let's have a look, Splodge.
Certainly, Beef. I bet I can guess what's in your box, Beef.
All right, then, guess.
Sandwich?
No.
Chocolate biscuit?
No.
Oh,
he'll
give us a clue.
Guess, will he?
Oh, I know. No. Itching powder.
The light came down somewhere near here.
Oh, look, Tom. An old friend has come back to see you.
The Astro Dragon!
Hooray! You came back!
Whoa!
The new moon must be his home.
You better take him back there, Tom. We can't have a fire-breathing dragon setting everything alight.
Can't he stay for a little while, Dad?
Oh, all right, then. But remember, we've got to find something for the clucks to eat. Otherwise, I'll have to take them to the market.
There must be something for him to eat on the new moon. Perhaps the clucks could eat it too.
Well, it's worth a try.
Come on, Dinko.
Good luck.
I heard that moons are made of cream cheese. I wonder if we could eat that new moon, Splodge.
Have you gone completely bonkers, Biff?
It'd be a change from slime curd, Splodge. Just think. Cream cheese sandwiches, cream cheese pastry, cream cheese souffle, cream cheese soup, cream cheese omelette.
Stop, all right. I suppose we could go there and have a look.
Goodie, Splodge. Would you like to take a trip to the moon? Yes, you would, wouldn't you? Okay, Splodge, we're ready.
This is our last chance, Clarissa. Cross fingers. Sorry, Clarissa. Cross feathers.
Oh, it doesn't look much like cream cheese close up.
Oh, yes, Blodge, try some.
Oh, yuck. Oh, it's terrible. What a place. Come on, Biff, let's get out of here.
Oh, what a strange place. Look, the dragon's gone over there by those funny-looking plants. Oh, I hope Clarissa likes it, Dink. Hooray, she likes it. And there's enough food here for a million clucks. Oh, little dragon, can you look after Clarissa until we get back?